Everlasting word in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 4. It tells you and shows you that he has covered us. We can participate with him in everything.
Yeah.
Because of the fact that we are in Christ,
yeah.
Our participation is divine, and it is in Christ.
Yeah.
And so if you don't know him today, the pardon of your sin, if you're not in Christ, I hope you take away something from this message.
Yeah.
It's not about an Eastern worldview, and it's not even about a biblical worldview. Uh-huh. It's about how you view God.
Well,
it's about how you view Christ.
Uh-huh.
And that's how you view the Bible.
My Lord.
And so I don't know about you on today. Paul is teaching us something here about being in Christ. Mm-hmm. You should look at what your spirituality looks like. What does your spirituality look like? And that's the question you have to answer. You don't have to talk in dialogue with me. I've been teaching it in Bible study for the last couple of Wednesday nights that I've been teaching Bible study. But you have to ask yourself the question, what does your spirituality look like now? Now that you fasted and you prayed for almost 28 days, you got three more. What does it look like? It has nothing to do with you losing weight. And you looking good when you put your clothes on. Just saying. It has nothing to do with that. Has everything to do with what have you gained through this journey? What have you gained through this fast? What have you learned about yourself that you didn't know before? Have you discovered anything? Have you learned anything about yourself that you need to change? You know, you think you got all the right answers. You think you know it all. You think you can tell your wife, or you think you can tell your husband this and that, but in this fast, have you checked yourself? You need to check yourself. Y'all need to check the pastor. Y'all can check me. I'm already checked. I'm checked by the Holy Spirit. You can check me.
Come on.
I'm already checked. Now, if I'm wrong and I'm out of place, check me.
Uh-oh.
I can be held accountable, man. I ain't gonna get defensive if you say, hey, pastor, you know what you just said. You know that all right. So I ain't gonna get defensive and be like, you can't tell me what to do. I'm a pastor. But I'm talking about theologically now. Check me. Check me by the word. I gave you the word. Check me and see if it don't line up. Check me. Now, here's what the question is, though. The question is, what does your spirituality look like? What does it look like? Do you look like Christ? Do you think you're mirroring Christ when you stand before others that you know that are lost and on their way to a burning hell? Do you believe that Christ emulates from you? Do you think you show the love of Christ? Do you think you bear fruit when you out there in the world before people in the marketplace? You know, when you out shopping and, you know, that might have not been a good example this morning for me to just stop and just look at her and say, you stupid. But guess what? She was acting stupid. I sent me out because she almost ran into me. I didn't need to say nothing back to her, but I know she was cussing me out. I didn't even get mad. I got upset because she had a baby in the back seat and you ran the stop sign and you got mad because I blocked you because you would have hit me if I would have blown my horn and stopped. That's what upset me. And you got a baby in the car. Suppose that would have killed the baby. Now, who would have been at fault? Would I have been at fault? No, because I had the right of way. And I stopped because I saw her. She was still coming. I thought she was going to stop at the stop sign. That's all I said. It's a stop sign right there. Has God told you to stop something? Have you thrown the stop sign in your face? And told you to stop. Because you know you won't write. Mm-hmm. I'm just in Christ. I mean, God's throwing stop signs up and warnings at us all day long.
Yeah.
He's doing it all day.
All day. Mm-hmm.
Have you taken heed to stop, look, and listen? Because he's calling us, listen, God calling people out of the earth every day. Billy Graham is gone.
Yep.
One of the monarchs of evangelical Christianity.
That's right.
I call him one of the monarchs because because he's been here for 99 years. Yes. There are millions of people in Christ that say, gone away from here. A whole bunch of people leaving here all the time. Have you stopped and looked at the signs? The signs of the time, you can't tell the seasons apart. One day it's cold, one day it's 90 degrees. That's people right. Wearing flip-flops and t-shirts, and they're going to have awful coming visits. On the knees. They might be 20, but when Arthur get in you, you feel like you're 80. Your heart hits you. You feel like you're 80. You can't move. Feel you hump. Can't straighten out nothing. All right, y'all. Come on, we get ready to go. I'm through with this. I'm coming back for part two.
Amen.
Amen. I got a hand.